welcome you to the month of prophecy. God is very faithful. And in this month, God will be faithful in your life, and God will be faithful in my life. I want to show you some certain things that will help us understand why we refer to this month as the month of prophecy. Amen. Come with me, please, to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah 42. Isaiah 42 verse 5. Are you there? Isaiah 42 verse 5. I need you to read the first line with me. Why don't you let us go? Thus saith the Lord. Is it the same thing in your Bible? Can we say it together? Thus saith the Lord. Isaiah 43 verse 14. Isaiah 43 verse 14. Can you read the first line with me again? Thus saith the Lord. One more time. Can we read it together? Thus saith the Lord. Come with me again to Isaiah 44. Isaiah 44 verse 6. Can we read the first line together? Want to let go? Thus saith the Lord. One more time. Thus saith the Lord. Come with me to Isaiah 44. Isaiah 44 verse 24. Isaiah 44 verse 24. Can we read the first line together? Want to let go? Thus saith the Lord. One more time. Thus saith the Lord. Come with me to Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45 verse 19. Can we read the first line together? Verse 18. Everybody, for thus saith the Lord. One more time, for thus saith the Lord. Okay, come with me to verse 11. Verse 11 of Isaiah 45. Everybody, the first line again. For thus saith the Lord. One more time, for thus saith the Lord. Okay, come with me to Isaiah 49. Isaiah 49 verse 7. Isaiah 49 verse 7. First line again. Thus saith the Lord. One more time. Thus saith the Lord. Come with me to Isaiah 56. Isaiah 56 verse 1. Want to let go? Thus saith the Lord. One more time. Thus saith the Lord. Isaiah 65. Isaiah 65. Come with me to verse 8. Let's read together. I want you to let go. Thus saith the Lord. One more time. Thus saith the Lord. Alright. Isaiah 66. Isaiah 66 verse 1. He says what? Thus saith the Lord. One more time. Thus saith the Lord. Genesis chapter 1. Genesis chapter 1. I'm just going to take two verses. I'm not going to take everything. Verse 6. Can you read with me? And God said, let there be. Is it the same thing in your Bible? Verse 6. And God said what? Let there be. Come with me to verse 14. And God said, let there be. Talk to somebody and say, it is time for the prophecy of God to come to pass in your life. There is a part said the Lord for you in this month that you will not miss. There is a thought said the Lord for you in this year that you will not miss. You want to lift up your right hand and ask the Lord, Father, release a word concerning me. Release a word concerning my family. Release a word concerning my household. Father, I need my thought said the Lord. I need my thought said the Lord. I need the prophecy of my life. I need the prophecy of my destiny. I need the prophecy of the future. I need the prophecy of this year. It is high time, O Lord, let the thought said come to pass in my life. Let the thought said the Lord take effect in my life. This is the month of prophecy, the month of let it be so. You Makar Elebos, let it be so. Let there be, let there be, let there be, let there be. Terebosho Tayadalaba, let there be, let there be. The month of God said the Lord. Terebosho Tayaba, the month of God said the Lord. If you are fed up of that situation, ask the Lord, it's high time, oh Lord, remember me. I need my thoughts feared. I need my thoughts feared, the Lord. I need my thoughts feared, the Lord. That is time, remember me. Jehovah, I need my thoughts feared, the Lord. I need my thoughts feared, the Lord. I believe you can do it. Jehovah, I believe you can do it. I know you can do it. My hope is in you, Lord. My trust is in you, Lord. There are so many God fear the Lord. God fear the Lord. Father, I need my unique God fear the Lord. That delivers me, O God, from every obscurity, from every frustration, from every hopelessness. I need my God fear the Lord that will make me unbounded. That will make everyone around me to know that God is God. Tell it in the name of Jesus Christ. Psalm 23. Psalm 23. I guarantee you on that door, you will not leave here without an assurance from God. You will not leave this service without your own past fear the Lord. We need a thought here, the Lord, so that Psalm 23 verse 4 can be a reality. Yay! Verse 4 says, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff will comfort me. We are studying the function of a man in a home, the function of a wife in the home, and the place of the children. We read and we study the path that can make a woman change even when she doesn't want to change. We studied also what could make a man change even when he doesn't want to change. The long and short of it all is that counsel will put it back in place. He says, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. You need God said the Lord to comfort you and to comfort me. Because whether you believe it or not, we are all walking through the valley of the shadow of death. Some people say that life itself is a risk. The fact anywhere you find yourself, there is an element of risk in that situation. Oh Lord, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil if you give me a word. If there is a thought said the Lord that takes care of me, then I will have no reason to fear. Somebody talk to the Lord. Somebody talk to the Lord. Daddy, give me my own unique word. Daddy, give me my own unique word. Daddy, give me my own unique word. That will make me not to fear. That will make me not to panic. Santore Belebelebos. Ira Baba Baba Baba. Tere Valide. Santorebos. I need my God fear the Lord. I need my God fear the Lord. So that when I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Without the assurance of God, fear will take over my life. Without the assurance of God, that bomb will break. Without the assurance of God, that business will crash. Without the assurance of God, that studies, are you sure you're going to make use of it? How are you sure when you study you will not come out and get it frustrated like other people? Only the word of God can assure us of tomorrow. Only the word of God can take care of the risk that is about to come forward. Thank God for insurance company. But even the insurance company need to be insured. Only God can insure us all. We need God fear the Lord. Daddy, give me my prophecy. Give me the unique prophecy of my life.